of musical study to the next one. And as you've experienced tonight, poets have wonderful, they're amazing with words. And about the next poem that is going to be the performance is about James Kilgore. He was a Cleveland poet. I worked with him. I was fortunate enough to work with him at Cuyahoga Community College. And while he was there, he was like the dean of poets during that time. James Kilgore was born in Jackson Parish, Louisiana. And he had a wonderful way with words. He was born in 1928, and he died in 1988. So he's not with us now. I was fortunate enough to be his colleague at Community College. And, you know, we have poets, people in general, have just sometimes troubled lives. And James Kilgore was a chronic alcoholic. And we loved him at the college, but he never really was able to conquer this disease. And what happened to him was that in his home, he set it on fire with smoke and drinking, and happened to kill himself, plus his daughter. So he, as I said, he was an amazing, amazing person. But this tragedy happened to him. And he really loved blues. So a lot of his poetry is about blues and hearing the blues. But the happenstance of his life, I just really took a liking to the short poem that you're going to hear. I breathe poetry, and this to me was James Kilgore. He actually definitely breathed it. I said it for soprano and cello. Cello, of course, my husband was a cellist, I was a cellist, so basically I said, well, let me try to set this for poetry and soprano. So we want to welcome the performers up, Kimberly Jones, soprano, and her Lessie, cello.
Thank you. probably will not want me to tell you this, but her husband was the first black cellist in a major symphony orchestra in the United States. He was cellist in the Cleveland Symphony Orchestra, one of the best string sections in the country, of course. CSO has a, Chicago Symphony Orchestra has the best brass section, but Cleveland has one of the strongest string sections in the world, and that is due in part to Donald White, Dolores' late husband. So I think they're ready now. Please welcome Kimberly and Dolores. She has one more setting of a poem by a Cleveland poet. Is that correct? Okay, please welcome them.